Just take this opportunity to introduce to you the technology, which is now the technology of future. I represent RSI Softech India Private Limited, based in Hyderabad. This company is in the field of geospatial technology for almost 30 years. 1985, it was formed by Mr. Sesha Rao. And I've been working in this company for the last 5 years. And when I look at this UAV mapping, I straight away go back to my 1981 time when I was there in academy. And for the first time, preparing a panorama map, sitting across a hill feature, and doing the drawing and then preparing it. And as I grew into this field, I realized how much change it has taken. But of last 2-3 years, the change is phenomenal. It's very simple, so easy to handle. As the previous speaker was mentioning, that you just give the lat long, you just give the path, and the system comes back to you. During this course of my short duration of presentation, I'll just give you a small brief introduction. RSI Softech happens to be the first company in this country to have done UAV mapping, and there are a lot of restrictions on it. But only thing that I can suggest is, let's stick to the rules of the country as of today. And it is the government organizations which help us, which are going to take the lead. All UAV mapping, all these things has to be under the government supervision. You all have seen through the slides how the advantages, terrain mapping, modeling, that all it can do. I'll not like to waste much time there. As you see in this, you can see from satellite imagery how we have, from the aircraft mapping to satellite imagery to ground-based sensors and then finally to UAV. A very simple method, you need to have a little map, carry out a flight plan, how you're going to do the thing, be more deliberate, and then you can get the data. As you have seen, a small payload-based UAV. You create large number of simple images and then put them into a software, and it is the software that finally develops the 3D modeling. And then on top of that, the same image sits and you get a beautiful 3D picture. This is how those number of images have been created, and a 3D modeling has been created from the computer, and the output comes. A small analysis. It's the data which gives you so much of accuracy, so much of liberty to do what all you want to do, how you want to utilize the data. I will just show you a small area where we have done a little tracking. This is a satellite data of 60-centimeter resolution of area Hyderabad, Kokatpally, where my office is there. And we have done a little bit of flying over that area. And I'll just show you the output, how it comes out. This is the area where we have done you can see the hand where we have done the mapping, and output you'll be showing you. If you just see, this is the our office complex, and what all accurately you can measure. The road, the width. to measure the width of the road. Now, this is the way I just want to show you that how accurately we can see the data. This is a building with the height. The accuracy part, you can just see it. Even on the satellite imagery, it just sits there where the office is. This is the office complex, I mean my own office, and this is a building sitting there. So this is the accuracy, this is the kind of information that you can get, the height, the width, even to the extent that we have certain these objects like a water tank, how clearly it is visible. Now, earlier Mr. Vishnu was mentioning about the quantum of activity that is available, and clubbing all those activity with this kind of accurate data that you have, you can create it's up to you what you want to actually do with this data. For the agriculture people, for the people on the, for the defense, for other organizations, the advantage today is the UAV data is available to you in less than 48 hours. With this kind of accuracy, you carry out the survey of the area, get into your high-end system, download the data, and give it to the user. Only problem that we face is, and rather it should be, once the data is taken out from the UAV, it should be under the control. And today, the best control, I mean, we have seen it, and we are working with Department of Science and Technology. We are working with Nectar. They are handling the data. We just download, give it to them, work in their premises, and then give it to the end user. The security of the data must be ensured. There is no two-way about it. And this is the best thing which is going to be coming up in the future for the country. Thank you very much. Any questions you'd like to ask? You see, we are doing with the Nectar in certain area of Jharkhand where there's a lot of forest cover there. Unfortunately, when you use this kind of a data, it may not be possible. But the moment you go over to using the LiDAR, if you use the LiDAR data and simultaneously use this data, you can resolve this issue.
Thank you so much, sir. Now I would like to request Sri Siya Garg to kindly present mementos to our speakers. Colonel A.K. Singh.